We need people to go to work. We need people to love these jobs, and we need people to want to be on the career paths that we provide here. And I think that the reason why I enjoy coming to work every day is because I get a chance to see that happening for a student every single day.
We provide them with the skills and train them on the skills to then give them that job so that they can be successful in life and move out of poverty and take care of themselves, take care of their families.
Summit gave me a new lease on life. I can help myself, I can help my family, friends, and build a life for myself rather than me just working for a paycheck and living hand to hand.
Now you have the pandemic, a technology explosion, and what they call the sans-demic. Without people, we don't have enough people. So people, hear this. They need you. Get a skill. Get something that you can trade across the table in the marketplace so that no matter what happens, somebody needs you.
You know, creating a GED program was a lot of, you know, effort and funds, you know, to do that. And we did it, and it proved to be very successful. We're one of the top GED programs in the state.
People just kind of assumed that I had that credential, but I didn't. And I wanted to have it because it feels better. And I wanted to walk the walk. I say, man, what did I wait so long for? I could have knocked this out a long time ago.
You come in here, you meet a different set of people. They're all trying to get somewhere. That's a change. You actually acquire skills and education. That's a change. So all this metamorphosis takes place over the 20 weeks.
It's just getting closer to the promised land. They just told you that, like, you know, trust the system. Sure enough, like, I was able to power through to graduation, and from going from not being able to, like, pay my bills to, like, think about, like, my future, I'm no longer stuck in the present. It's nice to, like, think about a future now. It's a privilege I don't think I've had for quite some time.
It's like Summit in the construction program. Summit is known for that, and we built that, and that's matured. The IT is next. There's just no doubt that just the future workforce is IT.
So Summit had to get into help desk, had to get into network operations, had to get into app development. All the things that make today's Corvette run, we want to be the people who are there and provide our students the access to those tools.
For me, this was completely brand new. And so the more I realized as I was going through the program, what I was getting into was, man, more than just some money, I was getting into job security.
It's important to introduce kids to STEM because that's where the careers are. It's where everything is headed. I've seen what good, solid programming can do for a community. And I think it's important on the north side of Minneapolis because you just can't get enough educational opportunities to serve all of the kids that are here. I think the thing that really has allowed us to make all of these changes has been contributions from our from philanthropy. It's been the corporate sponsorships. Some of the things that we're hoping that sponsors will do for us and with us would involve things like supporting our students and the programming that they're in.
We need more employers. The employer engagement is huge for us. What Atomic Data and U.S. Bank has done, when you really engage like they've engaged with us, we pretty much set our employer standards around that.
When we build talent locally and bring talent up, we create that talent, we create loyalty, we create, you know, strength within our community.
We don't want this to be something that's proprietary to ourselves, because that doesn't benefit the community at large, and that's really the goal here, right, is to make sure that the community itself is prospering and growing, and that individuals who haven't ever thought of IT or thinking about IT now, and that they have a pathway to be successful within that career.
And that's why I think what really separates us from other schools, other organizations like ours too, is, you know, with school, nobody pays 1 cent out of their pocket to come to Summit. That's why we annually raise the funds and contracts, and we get the support of our corporate groups. It's because it's not about us, it's about them.
I struggled with homelessness for a while I was in school, and I didn't have any support from my parents financially while I was in college. So I've had a completely different situation at Summit where, throughout the whole process, people are making sure that I'm getting what I need.
it's definitely one of the things that drew me. Like, it's definitely a once in a lifetime kind of opportunity where you have somebody that believes in you and your success, wants to remove all of the barriers that they can for you. I think that doesn't come around very often in your life.
You know, we have people come from all walks of life. You know, you can't take a pencil and erase them off the planet. You just can't do that. But what we can do is open your arms and your hearts to them and say, here's a space for you. And we can help transform your life.
You need more summits doing this work. And if you can't get more summits, then find a way to leverage what Summit does and spread it to those places where people don't have the opportunities.